Greetings, friends.
And welcome back to Pokémon Legends Arceus.
Yeah, time to go to the next two lakes.
Yeah.
Valor and Acuity.
Yeah, we'll probably have to do a survey for those other Pokémon, too.
Yeah. How has your overall experience been?
Looks like that worked out well, Tom.
I must say, you know an awful lot about Hisuivolo. I suppose a merchant like you sees all sorts of things in their travels.
That's right. You could say it's because I'm a merchant, but mostly I'm just naturally filled with curiosity. I want to know exactly what happened in the past that led us to this particular present. Or more accurately, I suppose, I want to know where I came from and where I'm headed. I want to know my path, so to speak.
The same goes for me. Our clan settled at the very spot where our forebears once beheld Almighty Sinnoh, but I have still never seen Almighty Sinnoh for myself.
Weighty matters to ponder, for sure, but we have an important task before us. Do you want to return to Mistress Kogita's home?
Yeah, let's go back.
Perfect. I'd like to see what she thinks of our progress.
Hopefully she'll just be like, good job, one of the next.
Right.
But I'm assuming she's probably going to have a bunch to say. Yeah. Mm-hmm. She's sitting at her table. Yeah. She's ready to talk. Ah, Mesprit's plume. So the legends told it true, then the red chain must be real as well. I beg your pardon, Kogita, ma'am, but what do these Pokemon that represent the mind have to do with the red chain, and why exactly should it bind the world? Your doubt suggests a keen intellect. I see you're not your clan's leader for nothing. Without the mind, were the rift to widen and the very world to end, would we even know it? One might even say the world, time, space, all creation exists only because our minds are there to perceive it. Perhaps the red chain's purpose is to let one see creation as it truly is.
What? So does the mind create the world, but isn't it the other way around, or is it?
Such are myths, my child, teaching us about the world and their own incomprehensible ways. They urge us to think more for ourselves on the nature of Almighty Sinnoh and on the nature of the world in which we dwell.
You're absolutely right. Myth and legends are such a fascinating thing to study. In any case, all we have to do is to complete two more trials and we'll get the red chain.
How nonchalant you sound. How confident of success to which you contribute nothing.
That's right.
You tag along only for the chance to gawk at more ancient ruins.
Is this lady supposed to be old? She talks like she's supposed to be old, but she has literally like the same face as everyone else in this game. Wait, are my Pokemon healed? Okay, cool. Beheading. That was like... Is it this one? I guess so.
Yeah.
I was looking at the bottom where it said the Trial of Lake Acuity, and I thought it had to do with, like, which spot I was choosing or whatever. So I was just like, I'm gonna float over top of all of them, but no. Bone chill wastes. Bet I gotta go like up over this way. Yeah, like, he can't flap higher, but when he starts, he goes a little bit higher than where he was before, so... Alright. You rock, go! Number two. I'm here, guys.
Here we are, Lake Acuity. You know, I've been told it actually contains seawater as well. Nobody knows why, though. It could be a fluke of geography, or perhaps it's connected to a Pokemon somehow.
Let me just scan the QR code on my freaking phone.
Lake Acuity is protected by the Pokemon Uxie. When Uxie took flight, the knowledge to solve problems was born in people's minds. That's what the stories say, anyway.
Uxie? Suxie?
Scanning complete. The door is open.
A tool that can make caves simply appear from nowhere is quite a handy one to have.
I wonder what waits inside. Ugh, goodness.
I imagine there may be Pokemon in there protecting the lake's guardian. Take care.
No, I think I'm just gonna fuck around and find out. Enter.
Wonder what kind of mixed up Pokemon we're gonna have to fight this time.
I sense a chill in the air. What is this?
A menacing Pokemon stands before you.
Kowow. I think that's supposed to be like... Could that be the dreaded Baneful Fox? Yeah, no, I think it's Lycanroc, but like, watch him just be like different types than what he used to be.
Right.
I don't even know what to use against him. I guess I'll just use Graveler. I don't know. Kowow. Or Kowow.
Zoroark.
Oh, that's Zoroark? Zoroark? Okay, cool. That's awesome. He totally looks like Lycanroc.
Yeah, I was gonna say he kinda looked like Zoroark or whatever, but like, I couldn't remember the name.
Have you played Sun and Moon? Do you know like what Pokemon? It has no effect on him, so what type is he then? I guess Ghost and Dark? Okay. Oh, fantastic. I thought I was gonna get another turn. I was gonna do Agile style and then Strong style. Okay, well, Take Wall Ray in. Take this Strong style Liquidation. See ya.
Nice.
Yeah, I'll have to show you the picture afterward. He looks just like Lycanroc.
Yeah, I know what Lycanroc looks like.
Yeah. They're trying to call that Zoroark? The Baneful Fox. It is a Pokemon said to be filled with malice. We were told stories about it as children. I feel a mysterious presence. I also see some white clippings on parts of my clothes in this cave. Kune. Yeah, like, look at his pants.
Yeah.
Like, see, like a bad Photoshop job. Come, I will test your knowledge. Combi, Zubat, Unknown, Magneton, Dusclops. How many are their eyes? Tell me each one by one, yet all at once. Answer me. I'm ready to answer. Wait. He said Combi, Zubat, Dusclops, Magneton, and then what was the last one? Combi is 2, Dusclops is 1, Magneton is 3, Zubat 0. So that would be 6, and then what was the last one? I don't know, 8? Wait.
Oh, shoot, we have to tell him, like... I think we have to tell him, the number of eyes each of them had.
Come test your knowledge. Combi, Zubat, unknown. Okay, so it's 2-0-1-3-1. Okay. I'm ready. 2-0-1-3-1.
Yeah.
2-0-1-3-1. Answer me true if answer you would.
What?
Wait, what?
Man, I'm about to just Google this.
Does Combi have three? Oh, wait, no, Combi's got six eyes. Wait, because it's like three little dudes, right?
Yeah, and okay. Magneton's got three eyes, right?
Is it because they're all cycloptic, yeah, so it'd be, so it's 6-0-1-3-2?
Or does Dusclops
He's got one, yeah.
6-0-1-3-1.
Okay. Let me try again. Hey,
Sweet.
Take this piece of the spirit to bind the world once more. You're the chosen one. You solved my stupid riddle. Uxie's claw. He doesn't have claws. Okay.
He got nubs.
Yeah, four little nubs. Goodness, that was tricky, but only one more to go now. All right. Let's get the frick out of here.
Yeah, and let's go back and see that Lee on the way, because that's necessary.
Yeah. Kogita!
I assume all went well, Tom. Still, I must wonder, why don't they just give us the red chain? Why all this running about?
Right? Perhaps they mean to test whether whoever seeks it is worthy.
Perhaps you're right. Who knows what would happen if it fell into the wrong hands after all.
Though on the other hand, what use would those wrong hands have for it?
Who can say for sure? Maybe the red chain has some other use besides mending the world.
The red chain's as mysterious as this entire predicament we're in, but if we continue visiting the lakes, we'll get closer to an answer.
So shall we return to Mistress Kogita's home?
Yeah, let's freaking go.
Wonderful. Then we can see if Mistress Kogita has any more insights to share with us.
I mean, she probably just could be condescending like last time.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I can't stop yawning. Ugh. So that's Uxie's claw. I sense a warmth to it. I do have to wonder if anyone else has ever completed the trials of these lake Pokemon.
Indeed. Yeah, we might want to add just a dash more speed. Things in Jubilife Village are tense. Yeah, we could add more speed if we weren't wasting time here.
Yeah. What makes you say so?
It seems the Pokemon's been glimpsed on the other side of the rift. One of those Ginkgo Guild merchants informed me that Commander Kamado has raised a force. Not to survey the Pokemon, but to subdue it, should the need arise.
One of those Ginkgo Guild merchants, you make it sound as if you're not one of them.
Now, if a Pokemon truly were to appear from beyond the rift, what would become of everyone, I wonder?
Don't let Hisui's great vastness stop you, Tom. Let's go get the final item we need.
That's the spirit. I'll come watch this historic moment unfold, too.
Watch? Is that all you really do? Yeah, that's all anybody does here. Remember, once you've sought the third lake and found what's needed for the red chain, make for the shrouded ruins. And do it quickly. Alright. Third trial. Meyerlands camp. Yeah, this has been a fun game. It's just too much talking. Mm-hmm. Right into the trees. Mm. Boof. Last lake. We're gonna get another trivia question? Or just an interview?
We might have to battle this one, I don't know. Do you know about Lake Valor? It is said to have been formed by a volcanic eruption, much like Lake Verity. Though there are also other theories that say it was carved out in the midst of a Pokemon battle. This lake is protected by the Pokemon Azelf. When Azelf took flight, the will to do what needs doing was born in people's hearts, or that is what legend would have us believe.
My phone's beeping. Open sesame. Did it.
Oh, a cave appears where there was none, as if just for Tom, as if, like, the last two times.
Let's head in, Tom.
I imagine strong Pokemon could wait inside, protecting the Pokemon of the lake. Take care.
Just like the last two times. Alright, what's it gonna be this time? What an eerie space. Why would there be columns inside a cave anyway? Oh, great.
Creepy looking quillfish.
Yeah. A menacing Pokemon awaits before you. Watch yourself, Tom. Those quills look vicious. We, like, go to battle it, and it's like, Gyarados used him. Blah, right. Blah, blah, blah.
Meowth used this.
Fishing me.
Overkill?
Overquill? I guess it's like a new form or something evolved into that. Thunder Wave. Yeah. Take that. Oh. I thought I would get at least one more hit. Damn. Alright. Come on, Graveler. Bulldoze that baby. Oh. I should have seen that coming. I don't think I have anything else that can hit him for super effective damage, so yeah. I'm just gonna go for it! Kill him. No! Oh, sweet.
Nice.
Okay. You're done!
I'm surprised we didn't get poisoned at all in this fight.
I'm glad.
Freaking horns.
Yeah. Freaking sea urchin looking piece of crap. Alright, Azelf. I knew you could do it, Tom. Because you've done it twice before. That face he makes. Kyon. Show to me unyielding will. Strike me if you can. Oh. Wait, bombs? Are you meant to try and hit Azelf with them then? What? You seem to hear a voice inside your head. Will you abandon this folly? I'm not through yet.
It looked like we were about to hit him with that last one.
It did, and then he just disappeared.
Will you abandon with this valley?
It seems you had best give up. Will you continue regardless? I'm not through yet. Maybe I'm just supposed to
keep... Yeah, just keep missing. And then he's probably going to be like, good job. You kept on trying.
Yeah. Give up. You struggle in vain. Will you press on? I'm not through yet. Like,
how many times?
I'm gonna give it like another couple minutes, but if he keeps doing this stupid shit, I'm probably just gonna...
That's gotta be it.
Kyun. Okay. Please be done. Take this piece of the spirit to bind the world once more. I was like, am I doing something wrong?
This is a broken game.
Yeah. I got Azelf's fang.
He just pulls one of his teeth out for you.
Doesn't even look like he got teeth. That looked exhausting, but now we've journeyed to all three lakes. Cool, and I'm probably just gonna... Yeah, let's call it now, and then we can see what's gonna happen next time.
Yeah.
Alright, guys, thank you so much for watching, and we hope you'll join us next time.
Bye-bye.
Have a good one.